Hey y'all, it's Taylor here. Thanks for joining me in the kitchen, and we are going to keep stitching in the kitchen. So growing up, my mama had a sign in the kitchen that said, the only reason I have a kitchen is because it come with a house. She has millions and millions, I still pick at her about this today, of recipes. She hadn't used one of them, but she's got them if she needs them. The other thing that she always had was she always had aprons. They are beautiful, they're spotless because they've never had anything on them. She's probably, I don't know how many she's got. She's got at least 10 or 15 aprons. Just like the recipes, she never uses them, but again, she's got them if she needs them. So we're actually going to make an apron today. I may make her one and give it to her, probably not, but it's a good idea. But this is the waist apron. So it's extremely easy to do. It may not look like it is, but there are some intricate steps. So as I'm going along, please make sure that you've got your tutorial out and that you're following along with me, because there's a couple of things that may be tricky. So just make sure that you follow along in your instruction book, okay? So the first thing that you'll see there is that we're going to do three blocks. We're gonna sew them out just like you would any normal quilt block. If you've used our designs before, they're very easy. So we're gonna make pretty much three traditional quilt blocks, okay? And these guys are here. Again, these designs are on your CD, so they're beautiful. There's some free motion here. There's some beautiful designs here with some great thick embroidery on here. Again, you can change your colors to match your kitchen. But as you can see, we've got three just standard quilt blocks here. So what we're going to do is we're going to sew these together, again, just like you would any other quilt, okay? So we can see here that we have sewn these together. And as we always, do standard, we butterfly our seams open, as you can see here, okay? Again, standard, this run-of-the-mill quilt things for us. So we're actually going to line our pockets. So this is our lining fabric here. You can certainly leave it raw if you like, but again, we just wanted a really nice finished product, so we went ahead and lined it. So we are actually going to lay our piece here, our three pieces. We're gonna just lay it face down, okay, right sides down, and you want your lining right sides up. Again, refer to your instructions here, but we're just gonna lay it down, all right? And then we're going to just simply stitch these two things together. So we're going to sew these together right here on your seam allowance, okay? And we want to stitch in the ditch as well. So that just means going along and stitching in our seam allowance here. And we want to attach these two pieces together. So all on the outside here, stitch in the ditch, continue, stitch in the ditch, and go here. That's going to put those two together. Before we do that, though, it's a good idea to take your, as I like to call it, since we're in the kitchen, your pizza cutter. Some people call it a rotary cutter. I call it a pizza cutter, but take your pizza cutter and we're going to just cut this fabric out. Okay, that makes it easier sometimes to do that, but we're going to cut it the exact same size as our three blocks, and then we're going to sew it together. Okay, so once we do that, then we are going to actually, and again, your instructions will show you this, there's about a 5-inch gap that we're going to leave at the bottom, okay, at the bottom here, so that once these two are together, we can turn them inside out, all right? And then this is what it's going to look like here, all right? As you can see, we have our three blocks here put together, and then on the back is our beautiful back. So now we have lined our pocket, all right? Now to finish this, when you can see here the gap that we've left, about the 5-inch gap, you can either use steam a seam to put this together, you can hand sew that together, or you can kind of just leave it, because later when we attach our back to this, we're actually gonna sew over that. So that's kind of up to you. Again, refer to your instructions on the specifics there, but there's some options on closing that, or if you can just leave it open, all right? So then we're gonna take this, and we have our back piece here. Again, your instructions will tell you sizes and everything you need for the materials. So take whatever back fabric that you like, and we're going to take our three blocks and we're going to place it right side up on our back fabric. Now you wanna take into consideration your seam allowance at this point. So we want it about 2 inches in from the side, 2 inches from the bottom, and 2 inches from this side. At this point, the top does not matter, and this is gonna be the bottom of our apron. So again, face up, about 2 inches from the side, 2 inches from the bottom, and 2 inches from this side. And then once again, we're going to sew this together, all right? So we're just going to take this to our sewing machine and we're going to sew about 5/8 of an inch or whatever you're comfortable with here. We're going to sew right here. Again, refer to your instructions. We're going to sew along here. Again, if we've left this open, this is where this will close that for us. And we're going to go along all here, all right? We also want to stitch in the ditch here to close these guys together. Now remember, this is our pocket, okay? So we do not want to sew over the top here. We want to leave these open because if you sew this, then your apron will be pretty, but it'll be like a screen door on a submarine. It won't be too functional, okay? So we want to make sure that we leave these top three slots open. So again, refer to your instructions, but we're going to sew it together here. And we're gonna go and stitch in the ditch here. So go along the bottom, the sides, but don't sew the tops because again, you wanna be able to get things in here, okay? So here we have it, it's beautiful. We have attached this back we've attached our pockets to our front here. And again, like I mentioned earlier as well, if you have not closed this, you know, the bottom earlier with a steam seam or hand sewing, this is where this will close it for you, okay? So again, refer to your tutorial for your measurements, but we're gonna have two apron ties because you obviously need something to help keep your apron up. We don't want it falling. So again, we've got two long pieces of ties here. Again, this is one of the great things I love is picking colors and fabrics, so you can make this any color that you like. Of course, this is in my favorite color of green, naturally. But what we're going to do is we're gonna make two of these. So take one of these and we're going to just put right sides together, okay? And we're going to fold it, just kind of finger press it here. I call these our God-given irons. So you've got five of them here, so just take those bad boys and press it down here. And what we're going to do is we're going to want to sew this together, okay? So again, here, you can see that we're gonna close one end here, and then we're just gonna come along and close this entire edge, again, right sides together, but we're gonna leave one end open right here, okay? So then what we need to do is turn this inside out. So you can take a chopstick, you can take a butter knife, anything that's kind of long, you can stick in there. Obviously, you don't want it to go through the end, and we're gonna turn it inside out. So you can see here, we've just taken a knitting needle here, and we're going to turn that inside out. And then this is what it's going to look like, all right, beautiful. We can see here, so we obviously need two of those, so we're just gonna repeat that same step. So do that again. So once our ties are together, then what we are going to do is we need to attach them to our back. So we can see here that we have pinned this here, okay? So again, refer to your instructions for exact measurements and where to put this, but you want to match up your tie with the edge of your fabric lining here, okay? And just to make it look better and finish better, we put our folded side up here, okay? So you can see here, this is the side that we actually sewed together here. This is the folded side. Again, just those kind of details like that really, really help set it off. So we wanna pin it on this side and kind of, you know, get it straight here, but then all the rest, you can just kind of put in the middle here, okay? And we're gonna take our other one. Again, we need two ties, so we're gonna take our other one. We're going to take our finished side and we're going to pin it over here as well. We're gonna line it up here, pin it, and then also make sure it's straight for a couple of inches here, and then we'll just let it rest in the middle here, okay? Don't let it get too far down here, and you'll see why, because now what we're going to do is we are going to take our back piece, or actually our front piece, we're gonna take our pockets here, okay? And we're going to attach this now. Now, something to notice, again, like I mentioned when I started, is make sure you really follow along in your tutorials here, but this is the top of the apron. Hopefully we didn't sew those together like I mentioned earlier, so we wanna take the top of the apron, and this is also going to be the top of the apron here with our ties. So we're gonna take this, and we're going to lay this face down. And again, this fabric is right side up. This is right side down. So we wanna lay these down. And again, it does not matter about our ties. Just make sure they're kind of neatly in the middle here. You wanna lay this down, kind of match it up here. and we are going to sew these together. Now, to help that not move and to not have a cattywampus, you know, apron when we're done, you want to pin these together, okay? So make sure you pin these together. They don't trust me with pins because I get stuck and it just ends up a bad day and I have Band-Aids all over me. So we just want to pin these together along here. And we're going to just sew about a half inch seam allowance all the way around, okay? We do want to go over the top here. And we want to stop and we want to leave about a 2-inch gap at the bottom here, okay? Because we're going to turn this, just like we have several other things, we're going to turn this inside out as well. So we want to sew this together, okay? And here we have one that we have completed. So you can see here with our dark stitching that we have this sewn together. You can see our gap that we left here, about a 5-inch gap, but we've sewn this together. Now, just a quick note, we actually used the dark thread just to help you in the tutorial to see that better, but throughout the entire project, you wanna make sure that you always match your thread to whatever you're doing. And again, that's a beautiful thing. You can make it any color, you can do anything you like, okay? But if you like, make a green one and mail it to me. So that way I can give it to Mama and say, oh, look what I did. So you can look on our address look on our website for our address and send me some aprons. All right, so we're gonna leave this open and then we're going to just turn that inside out. When we do turn that inside out, then our apron is complete. So this is the completed guy here, all right? And to finish that, to finish that 5-inch gap here, you can just hand sew that together, all right? And the straps are on that we had in the middle. They're gonna come out, it's gonna be beautiful. And you're going to be the envy of all your guests with your beautiful, beautiful apron. So here's to stitching in the kitchen, and thanks for joining me.